Well, good Sunday, everybody. Decided to come out this morning and spend a couple hours on the boat. The rest of the rivets are sealed. This JB well's got to sit and cure overnight from here up there. Some of it was probably not necessary, but just in case. I went ahead and got the transom prepped for paint. Got it sanded real good, cleaned. And I've just got to put a coat on there to see what the color is going to look like. I think it's going to look very good. That is duck boat drab. Now, I've seen a picture of it in the book, but I've not yet opened the can. So we'll see. I think it's what I want. Let me get a coat on there and we'll look at it and see what it looks like. First coat. I think I'm going to like it. I'm going to let that dry for a couple hours. And if it don't rain, which it looks like it's going to, I'll put another coat on there. And we'll see what that looks like. Well, this color, if I decide to camo it, which I'm not sure, I still haven't decided where I'm going to or not. But if I do, this will be the perfect base coat for it. And it'll be easy to do. But I'm going to wait till I get the entire thing, two coats, at least two coats, maybe three if I got enough paint, because I got to save some for the top side when I flip it back over. And I'll make that decision later. That's not a big deal. Maybe not. So first coat, duck boat drab. All right, we'll look at it again in a little while. And what video from around here would be complete without a picture of the rain? That's okay. Rain. I don't care. I can still work. Now, I got the second coat on. Looks exactly like what I want it to look. Looks good. Now, the only thing I'm going to do different on the sides, not necessarily the bottom, because you won't ever see much of that. But on the sides, I'm going to invest in a quality paintbrush. Because you can see all the brush strokes in the back here, which I'm not concerned once I get the motor on it and everything. You won't notice it, and if somebody does notice it, I don't really care. But just for look's sake, because we have to look good on the water. Y'all know that. On the sides, I will get a little bit better brush than what I have. And do that. Now I've started sanding on the sides because it's still got a little bit of stickum and junk on it. So I'm going to go down it with an 80 grit paper on my random orbit sander, knock all that stuff off, and then I'll go back on each side with a 220 and maybe take it down one more grit to make sure it's nice and smooth. And the bottom, I would probably just go with a 80 grit or maybe a 60 grit just to smooth everything out. And hopefully by the end of this week, off and on, I'll have it all painted. We'll see. This JB well, like I said, it'll be cured by tomorrow morning. It'll be ready to go, right? Smooth it all out a little bit and paint it. Another picture of the rain. Oh well. And that will probably do it for today. It cooled off now, but I got very, very hot after I put the second coat on. I had to go inside and cool down and rest. I've got to be careful. Even though it's almost November or October, it's still very hot here. The humidity is just awful. I still got to be careful and not get overheated, and I am. I'm not going to get overheated. I do have a couple of knives to make this week. I got a couple to finish up the leather. I'll show you all those in a day or two. Now, I did a rant video, a very angry rant video yesterday. If you heard me mention that in the last video, I decided not to post that because when I watched it back, I was very, very angry. And without meaning to, I called a couple of names, business names. And that's not, I shouldn't have done that. So that's why I didn't post the rant video. If you hear me mention the rant, that's why you didn't see it. I went to the leather store yesterday to get leather. And I sat there for almost an hour past opening time. Nobody ever showed up. That's one thing that made me mad, because that is the only place in this area I can go and look at my leather and get it. I know I can order it online, but I would much rather go and look at what I'm buying and make sure it's what I want. And I wait, and they're closed today, Sunday, of course. Ain't got no problem with that. They're closed on Monday. So I'll try again Tuesday and see if they open. And they don't open until the middle of the day, 10:30. I'll see if I can't get what leather I need for a couple of sheaths to mail out. It's going to be another day or two on a couple of them, which I really apologize for. And after I get that, get caught up, and get ahead a little bit, I'm going to make a trip over to Mobile, Alabama. There is a Tandy leather store over there that has all kinds of leather that you can go in and look, and there goes a boat down the road. And you can actually pick out what you want. And it's about 45, 50, maybe even 60 miles over there. But I think once a month or two, it might be worth it just to go get what I need, because I know they'll be open when they're supposed to be open. And that's all I'll say about that. The last thing I want to tell y'all. Somebody asked me, what am I going to do with the big Evan Rood? Well, I could, as good a shape as it in, I could list it for sale. But I don't really want to do that, because it was a gift to me from Cousin Jay. It's a good motor. Very, very expensive if you want to go buy one, because I've looked at them. And now, that's not a brand new one, but a brand new 115 Evan Rood Johnson Mercury, don't matter what you get, a little over $10,000 if you want a brand new one. Now, here where I live, boats are a dime a dozen. You can get big boats big enough to go out in the Gulf, out in the big water, all day long sometimes for $300 or $400. The trouble is they don't have a motor on them. So if I was to run across a deal like that, a big boat, big enough where I can go out in the Gulf for a couple hundred dollars, and many of them are in very, very nice shape, except for no motor. I have a motor. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean it up good. I put a cover on it and keep it. Now, I could really, really, really use the money for a sale off of one of those, but I don't think I'm going to do that. I'm going to keep it. And that would, if I get another boat, that would put me a river boat, a big boat, and Old Faithful. And I see absolutely nothing wrong with having three boats. Do y'all? So, anyway, to answer the question, I'm going to keep it. I'm not going to sell it. I'm going to keep it. All right. That's going to do it. I thank y'all for watching. I thank you for your support. This project here should start moving pretty quickly. And I'll show y'all some more in another day or two. And to quote my buddy John Savage, see ya, bye.